Hello, YouTubers. This is the Noobifier. Today, we got a 20-minute calling all devs about ships and ship tech. Here's what you need to know in 2 minutes and 38 seconds. John Crew was asked about ship-to-ship docking and ship-to-station docking. John said they basically broke it down to three types: Connie to Merlin hard docking, ship-to-station docking, and ship-to-ship using docking ports. For Connies and their snubs, the pilot on the Merlin needs to request docking, and once approved, the pilot gets a custom docking UI. Once the Merlin is very close, the automated docking takes over. John said that there's been good progress on making this work. For ship-to-station docking, like what was demoed recently, John said that they were underway with a working prototype. Large ships would request, and the dock would extend. Ship-to-ship using a docking collar is a future nice to have and is not currently being worked on. John was then asked about physicalized damage, physicalized armor, and penetration. John confirmed that they're working on the initial parameters and the groundwork prior to making this come to life. John said that they would test this on a small set of ships, balance them, adjust the system, and then update the entire fleet. The SDF defines the shield bubble, which is used for re-entry effects and collision detection. John said that the SDFs are pretty much done, and the other teams are moving forward to implement the remainder of the tasks. John ended on that by confirming that the SDS would also be responsible for adjusting the flight behavior, for example, when a pilot loses a wing. Jared confirmed that they would do a future feature on this feature when appropriate. John confirmed that they're working to get the Aegis HUD to be bespoke to that brand. Individual HUDs and MFDs will work similarly and offer similar features, but they will all look and sound unique now that the building blocks are working as intended. John said that they still plan to give us the ability to spawn parasites within our larger ships at the ASOP terminal, but did not confirm when that will release. The Hull C was paused waiting for collapsible physics grids. John confirmed that the tech for ship-to-station docking also fixed one of the hull-related issues. Another blocker is scalable rooms, but because this is eventually needed to be standardized for the entire game, the Hull C is still on hold. John also said that the size of the ship also requires other changes in the cargo functionality. Jared asked where the Redeemer was, and John confirmed that it would be a full gunship as was demoed during Fleet Week. John then showed off the exterior with its upgraded weapons. John said that they decided to keep it Aegis despite it not working quite well with the normal Aegis style guide. You could clearly see two-man turrets without the need to go through a tube, the rear has a lower-mounted tail turret that appears to be remotely operated, and the pilot also has a chin turret. It still has a rear ramp. John ended by saying that it retained the familiar silhouette, and I think it looks great. There was no indication on when we might see that in engine. That's it. Fly safe, and I'll see you in the verse.